Hello guys, and welcome to another calculus video. Today we're going to be checking out this amazing sum, the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of sine cubed of n over n cubed, or if you prefer, sinc cubed of n. And we're going to be turning it into a sinc double integral. So buckle in and get ready for this amazing infinite sum. So if some of you remember my video where I did the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of sinc squared of n, you might remember that we converted sinc squared of n into an integral. And we're going to be doing the same thing right here. So you'll see first we'll just use our trig identities for sine cubed of n. So we're going to rewrite this as 1/4 sum from n equals 1 to infinity of, I believe it's, it's 3 sine of n minus sine of 3n. All over n cubed. And so now we're going to convert this into an integral. So what do we have to do in order to convert this into an integral? Last time we had 1 minus cosine of 2n, which we could just easily rewrite as cosine of 0 minus cosine of 2n. So we want to have two similar things subtracting one another, right? So the way we're going to do that is we're going to bring this 3 outside. So let's bring this 3 outside, and then we're going to have, this is going to be over 3, and this is just over 1, and again we're over n cubed. Now you can see that now we have sine of 1n over 1 minus sine of 3n over 3, which is really nice. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take this n cubed, make it n squared. That's not n squared. N squared right here, and then we're going to divide by n on the top. And now we can rewrite this as 3/4 the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of sine theta over theta evaluated at n and 3n all over n squared. And next, what we would usually do at this point is we would convert this into an integral by differentiating on the inside with respect to theta. But you may notice if we differentiate on the inside with respect to theta, we're going to end up with theta cos theta minus sine theta all over theta squared, which is just really nasty. And there's no real good way to reorganize this to become an easy to solve integral, or easy to solve sum, I should say, and integral. So an easier way to reorganize this is instead to take our function and turn it again into an integral. So notice that the integral of cosine of u theta d theta is equal to negative sine of u theta over theta. Or I'm sorry, this should be du, not d theta. Right? Just using our trigonometric integrals and the chain rule. And so this matches up really nicely with what we have here. If I rewrite this as 3n over n, I can put this negative sign in here. And this actually looks, if we just set u equals 1 right here, so our upper bound is 1, then that actually matches up exactly with what we have inside our brackets here. So, and of course, when u equals 0, then this whole expression goes to 0, right? So we can write this as the integral from 0 to 1 of cosine u theta du. So let's go ahead and write that in. And now we can go ahead and differentiate the inside with respect to theta and then rewrite this as an integral. So we're going to have 3/4 times the sum from n equals 1 to infinity times the integral from n to 3n of the integral from 0 to 1 of negative u sine of u theta du d theta all over n squared. Let's go ahead and make some more space. I'm sorry, I just noticed I missed a negative sign, or I had an extra negative sign in there from last slide, so this should actually be a positive. Sorry about that. And this is all going to be over n squared. And to get rid of this n squared on the bottom, that's super easy. All we have to do is set theta equal to nv. So we're going to end up with 3/4 the sum from n equals 1 to infinity. In this case, d theta is just going to become n dv. Now we're going to have the integral from 1 to 3 of the integral from 0 to 1 of u sine of u vn du d theta, just bringing that n outside and canceling it out on the bottom. Next, all we're going to do is take these integrals and take them outside and put the sum on the inside here. So that's just going to look like, I could take this u out as well. The sum from n equals 1 to infinity of sine of uvn du d theta, all integrated from 0 to 1 and from 1 to 3. All right, nice. And we also have this u out here. And now, in order to do this sum, it's super simple. We're just going to take the imaginary part of e to the I uvn. And then we're just going to take this imaginary operator outside the sum, right? And so now we can rewrite this as e to the I vu. Sorry, this is a v raised to the n. Remembering that sum from n equals 1 to infinity of x to the n over n equals negative ln 1 minus x. So we're going to get 3/4, this is the integral from 1 to 3, from 0 to 1, u imaginary part of negative ln 1 minus e to the I v u. Now, in order to simplify this, it's relatively simple. The imaginary part of a complex natural logarithm is just going to be the argument. And an easy formula for the argument, in this case, the formula only works when the real part of the imaginary number is greater than or equal to 0, which is true of this function in here. So we can go ahead and use it. It's going to be inverse tangent of the imaginary part over the real part. So in this case, the imaginary part is negative sine of vu, and the real part is 1 minus cosine of vu. And so this part, actually, all you have to do is, if you substitute in the double angle identities for cosine vu and sine vu, you can pretty easily show that this is going to be inverse tangent, negative inverse tangent of cot of vu over 2. And if you want to see how that's done, you can check out my earlier video where I solved the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of sine squared of n over n squared. I did the exact same thing. So we're going to have negative tan inverse of cot of vu over 2. So we can just go ahead and substitute that in. Okay, so now this tan inverse of cot, in general, tan inverse of cot is going to be pi over 2 minus x, right? Tan inverse of cot of x is going to be pi over 2 minus x. Now, we do have to be careful here, because if that only holds true for a very small range of values, because cotangent x is this periodic function, so it'll only work in that first period of cotangent x. So that would mean x has to be between 0 and pi, or I guess pi, right? Between 0 and pi. Luckily for us, u is between 0 and 1, v is between 3 and 1, so uv is between 0 and 3, which is less than pi. And so uv over 2 is also less than pi, right? So we can substitute in that formula and integrate much more easily. All right, now all we have to do is solve this relatively simple integral. So we can go ahead and multiply out right here. We're going to get u pi over 2, u squared. So when we integrate from 0 to 1, that's going to be super easy. We're just going to get 3/4 integral from 1 to 3 of pi over 4 minus v over 6. dv. And so we're just going to get 3 fourths times 3, or I guess since we're integrating from 1 to 3, we're going to get times pi over 2. And then we're going to be subtracting. I guess I'll just integrate this normally. So we're going to have, it's going to be what, v squared over 12 evaluated at 3 and 1. So we're going to have 9 minus 1 over 12. So overall, we're going to have 3 fourths times pi over 2 minus 2 thirds. So overall, we're going to have 3 pi over 8 minus 1 half. And that matches up if you were to line up the sum from n equals 1 to infinity, or the sum from negative infinity to infinity of sinc cubed of n with the integral from negative infinity to infinity of sinc cubed of n, you would see that this actually perfectly matches up with that result. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This video already was pretty crazy, but it's about to get crazier because pretty soon I'm going to be able to record a similar video with sinc to the 4th of n, and after that sinc to the 5th of n. And those videos are going to be much longer since they're more complicated, and we're going to get to do triple and even quadruple integrals. So absolutely stay tuned. I'll try to get those videos out soon. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to let me know if you have any questions about the methods used in the video, and yeah, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.